Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, and on our main topic, the 14th General Conference of the Islamic World Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization, and the meeting being held here in Egypt. We're glad to be joined over the phone by Dr. Atif Askar, Islamic researcher at Al-Azhar University. Hello, sir, and thank you for joining us.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for joining us. Well, sir, how do you view the importance of holding this meeting, the 14th meeting of the Islamic organization here in Egypt?
Alhamdulillah, salatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. Let me say that it's very important to hold such conferences and events here in Egypt and UNESCO as one of the organizations which supports education, science, and culture. And Egypt at the moment is in a very dire need to share the interest of 51 member states to promote education, science, and culture. Actually, in the previous 7 years, we've been doing all of our efforts in Egypt here to promote education and science and culture. And
yes,
that's why I see the importance of this conference is highlighting the efforts that we've been doing through the previous 7 years.
Yes. Sir, to what extent does Egypt succeed in supporting the African and Islamic countries in the fields of education, science, and culture?
In fact, holding this conference in Egypt at this moment is a proof that we open the door for our neighbors' countries to promote education and science and culture. We've been in Africa and in Arab countries suffering from ignorance and the absence of good education and promoting the science and culture and actually the intercultural dialogue and the intercultural activities. Egypt at this moment is opening the door to all the countries, and especially the countries that UNESCO is sharing here. We are telling the whole world now we are ready and prepared to support any kinds of education and culture and science, and especially in the fields that UNESCO is working on.
Yes, sir, one of ESASCO's objectives is to contribute to world peace and security through various means, publicize the true image of Islam and Islamic culture, promote dialogue among civilizations, cultures, and regions. How do you assess this?
Yes. Let me say that one of the most important elements that the West has a bad image, actually, about Islam is that they don't know Islam, and they even they're even fed by a bad image about Islam. And Muslims and Arabs, in fact, to be honest and to be clear. And the matter here is that dialogue is a vital tool to recorrect this image once more and to reflect the true image of Islam in the West.
Yes.
Actually, the people in the West are thirsty to know more about Islam and to learn more about the true image of Islam. And we need to say that actions speak louder than words. Those calls for violence and those calls for rights and these things will not result in any kind of peace or tolerance or coexistence. Such conferences are highlighting the efforts that we've been doing to recorrect the thoughts and to recorrect the image of Islam here in Egypt and in the Arab countries and actually the whole world, that we are spreading the peace and security through the good morals that Islam is spreading in the 14th decade.
Yes, well, I would like to thank you very much, Dr. Atif Askar, Islamic researcher at Al-Azhar University. Many thanks for your insight. And dear viewers, now we go to a short break and we'll be right back.